Okay, in today's video, we're going to make a large house sign made out of PVC. So lately, quite a few of our packages have arrived at the neighbor's house. I mean, there's been several times when I've been waiting for a package, and then I just see the UPS truck drive by. And I think the problem is that our house sign is just too small. And we live in the country, so the sign is not on the house, it's like farther down the driveway. So I think what we need is a bigger sign, something visible and clear and off the ground a bit. So that's what we're going to make today. In terms of material, I'm going to use PVC. You can buy sheets of this at the home improvement store. This is a 4x8 half-inch sheet, which costs about $70. So you can make quite a few signs with this. Now, obviously, you could use wood if you prefer. However, it is hard to beat PVC since it won't get worn down over time or need to be repainted. There's less maintenance. Here, I'm taping the areas that are going to get cut. And that's simply so later it will be easier to paint the letters and numbers without getting the paint everywhere. I'm going to use my CNC machine for this job, but obviously you could use a router and a template. To engrave this, I'm using a 90-degree V-bit. And for this video, I'm making a Darben Orver sign, since I prefer to keep my private address private. But it's going to be the same size, and I wanted to make a Darben Orver sign anyway, so this works out great. So I just barely cut the sign all the way through on the edges and then finished it off with a razor blade. And the 90-degree V-bit really does a great job of making crisp engravings. It's that angle that makes the letters look really, really awesome. Now for paint, I'm using this black exterior Rust-Oleum spray paint. And I just sprayed a little in a cup so I can apply it with a foam brush. I found that it makes it a little bit easier to control that way. And then it's easy enough to just remove the tape, which makes it a lot easier than if you were painting this freehand. And then to remove any imperfections at all, it goes away really easy with a little bit of sanding. Okay, so that's a sign, but now we need a nice way to display it off the ground. So we're going to start with digging a hole.
So before starting to dig, I thought it would be nice to clean up the shovel. Seeing some rust here. The WD-40, Specialist Penetrant, Fast Acting. You know, the thing is, if you clean your tools before you start using them, they don't get as dirty. So once I'm done using the shovel, I'm going to use this WD-40 Specialist Corrosion Inhibitor. Ideal to use on equipment before storing.
So I want to say a big thanks to WD-40 for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. So to hold the sign, there are obviously many ways you can go here, but we decided to go the same plastic route to match. So picked up this hollow fence post from the home improvement store. This is an 8-foot 4x4 post. First up, cutting a hole through it and just using a jigsaw here. And also just cutting it slightly to make it a touch shorter. Now back to the PVC sheet on the CNC machine and cutting up 3 strips here. And obviously you could cut this with a table saw or a circular saw or whatever. then mixing up some epoxy to glue these sections together and clamping while drying. So this PVC block will go through the post here, so just making sure it's going to fit through. Now the way we're going to secure this is to simply dig about a foot deep and then adding some fast setting concrete. So this post is really light, so we're mixing up some regular concrete and filling part of the post to secure it even better. And then washing the shovel here, and now it can be sprayed with the WD-40 product again and be stored until next time. Okay, then just sliding the thick board here through the post. And I secured little eyelet hooks to the sign, so then just screwing in some hooks into the post here to hang it off from. Now to make sure that the board was staying straight and not dipping down at all, we're adding some more hooks and some steel cable. So it's looking good. I also have a fence cap here, which I think really finishes it off nicely. And to completely seal it, adding some caulk here in the gaps. Oh, you know, another thing that I was thinking about is how easy it would be to add a couple of hooks on the bottom of the sign and then make additional signs that you can hang underneath depending on the time of year. So you could make one that says, you know, Happy Halloween or Happy Birthday or Merry Christmas or whatever. You can, you know, make them different designs and paint them or whatever. I think that would be kind of a nice feature, especially if you're having a party or a get-together or just, you know, mix it up a bit. So that would be something nice to do. So there are a couple of reasons why I like this. First of all, it looks really good. I mean, it looks very crisp and nice. And of course, I'm using the Darben Over sign, but it's easy to just switch off and put, you know, our house sign on. You can see it, you know, far down the road. The numbers are really clear, and I doubt that we're gonna get any more packages ending up at the neighbor's house. So mission accomplished in terms of that. Then also, all the materials for this job, I mean, they're quite affordable, and you can make, you know, several signs with a sheet of PVC like this. And of course, I was using my CNC machine, but you can easily use a router and a template, so there are, you know, different ways to accomplish the same goal. So, of course, I made this sign for my house, but you could just as easily use this technique to make a sign for your business or, you know, a larger apartment complex or whatever. There are lots of options here, and I really like using the PVC. It is such a nice material to cut. It's really crisp, and it looks really, really good. Plus, it's nice not to have to think about, you know, maintaining the sign or whatever. Definitely picture making a bunch of different signs for different things using this material. It's very nice. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you have any questions? Anything I wasn't clear about? This was like one of those neat little projects that was so useful. I've been meaning to get a better sign going for a long, long time. So I think this is going to be really good.
Bye.
Did you want to say bye?
Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.